Welcome back. You're watching Fight Back. 7 years after the alleged multi-crore City Limousine scam was perpetrated, the official liquidator appointed by the Bombay High Court has finally received a go-ahead to sell the company's assets and refund the depositors their money. In a recent order, the Bombay High Court has directed the Enforcement Directorate, the SFIO and the EOW to furnish details and hand over properties and assets of the company to the official liquidator in the next 3 weeks. Prerna Barua has this exclusive report.
In a big development in the alleged multi-crore City Limousine scam, the liquidation process of the tainted car rental company could soon be underway. The official liquidator appointed by the Bombay High Court has received a final go-ahead to liquidate the company's assets. The Bombay High Court has now directed all the investigation agencies, that is the SFIO, ED and EOW, to hand over properties and assets of the company to the official liquidator in the next 3 weeks. The order came after the official liquidation committee had submitted a status report before the Bombay High Court after inspecting the tainted company's records and properties.
The Enforcement Directorate and Economic Offences Wing of the Mumbai Police, who had attached properties worth over 200 crore rupees, will have to furnish details of the properties attached and bank accounts seized so far. The representatives of the official liquidator have also stated in their report that several banks have been directed to release the money lying in their accounts and hand it over to them along with interest accrued.
We have attached numerous properties of City Limousine. The retail inventory is ready with us. We have also invoked the provisions of Maharashtra Protection of Interest of Depositors Act, that is MPID. And based on that, we are willing to provide the list of attached properties to the liquidator as and when it is required by him.
The official liquidator also claimed that the investor base of the tainted company was extremely large and they have received over 40,000 claims so far. The official liquidator has also released advertisements in national dailies across the country inviting claims from the creditors of City Limousine and City Realcom. Notices have been released to creditors of both City Limousine and City Realcom to submit proofs of their respective debt or claims before April 30th, 2013, failing which they will be excluded from availing the benefits of dividend distribution. The Bombay High Court had earlier appointed an official liquidator for City Limousine in October 2010 and ordered to wind up the company in December 2010. The High Court also ordered winding up of City Realcom in March 2012.
Definitely, it is a positive step in the direction of liquidating the company and its assets and to give back the depositors' money. And as far as Honorable Bombay High Court is concerned, EOW has been made party to respond to the petition about our opinion, and we are going to give a positive opinion stating that it is a positive step, and EOW Mumbai has no objection in appointment of a liquidator.
To put the entire case in perspective, Saeed Mohammed Masood, the chairman of the alleged tainted car rental investment company City Limousine, had allegedly floated various schemes, luring thousands of investors across the country by promising returns as high as 48%. Under the scheme, investors had to make an initial investment of 97,000 rupees, for which the company offered 4,000 rupees every month for the next 5 years. The amount collected by the company was to be used to purchase cars, which were to be registered in the names of investors. The investors were then to be paid the profit from the income generated by giving these vehicles on hire. At the end of the 5-year period, the vehicle was to be returned to the investors. After collecting over 1,000 crore rupees from investors, the company had shut operations when more than 42,000 cheques issued by it to investors were dishonored. Over 20 FIRs have been registered against the company in Mumbai, Karnataka, Rajasthan, Andhra Pradesh and Delhi for criminal conspiracy, cheating and breach of trust under sections 120B and 420 of the Indian Penal Code. Masood was also booked by the Enforcement Directorate under Prevention of Money Laundering Act and was arrested in December last year.
Moving on, let us now redress some of your aviation and insurance-related grievances. Rakesh Kumar has sent us this email from Gurgaon. He alleges that Jet Airways did not cooperate after his wristwatch went missing from his checked-in luggage.
In an email to Fightback, Rakesh Kumar claims that he had travelled with Jet Airways from Bangalore to New Delhi on February 14, 2013. Rakesh further claims that his wristwatch went missing from the checked-in luggage. He also claims to have filed a complaint with the company. Rakesh further claims that the company officials assured a complete investigation of the matter and inquired about the value as well as the make of the watch. Rakesh also claims that company representatives assured to treat the case as a case in isolation. He alleges the company of not investigating the matter despite repeated follow-ups. In response to Fightback, Jet Airways says, and I quote, "The guest had travelled on Jet Airways flight 9W812 from Bangalore to Delhi on the 15th of February with a checked-in baggage. The guest complained to Jet Airways staff about a missing watch after he reached home. The security was informed, which carried out an investigation and found nothing amiss. The guest also did not complain about any damage to the lock or to the bag. As per aviation norms, guests are disallowed from carrying cash or valuables in their check-in baggage." End of quote.
Pramod Musale has sent us this email from Bengaluru. He alleges that Bajaj Allianz overcharged him for surrendering the policy.
In an email to Fightback, Pramod Musale claims that he had purchased an insurance policy from Bajaj Allianz Life Insurance. Pramod claims to have paid 12,500 rupees as premium for 3 years. He further claims that the company agents had assured him of complete fund value refund after 5 years on surrender of the policy. Pramod claims the company levied 10% surrender charges on the policy. He further claims to have filed a complaint with the company. Pramod also claims that the company representatives informed him of tampering with the original document. He, however, claims that the original document was intact and was not tampered with at all. Pramod alleges the company of charging an extra 10% surrender charge. In response to Fightback, Bajaj Allianz says, and I quote, "We have not yet received a request from the policyholder to surrender his policy except an inquiry of how much would he get if he surrendered his policy. When our Bangalore office informed him of the amount that he is likely to get as well as the breakup of that amount, he raised a query about the surrender penalty charges being levied as per the policy terms and conditions. When he submitted his policy document, it was found that the document was tampered with, as our standard policy document for that product contains 13 pages with ombudsman office addresses as per the guidelines laid down by the regulator. The surrender charges and other penalties are levied as per the terms of the policy, which were mentioned in the policy document dispatched to the policyholder at the time of initiating the plan 5 years ago. The policyholder has an opportunity to review the policy document within 15 days of the date of its receipt and intimate the insurer in case of any disagreement with the terms and conditions or if the policy document is found to be torn or tampered with. Since the policyholder did not opt for the free look cancellation of the policy and continued to enjoy insurance cover, it is presumed that he was satisfied with the policy as issued. In case the policyholder wishes to surrender the policy, a written request needs to be provided, after which the surrender value will be paid as per the standard terms and conditions of the policy. Till date, we have not received any request for surrendering the plan from the policyholder. On receiving such a request, applicable surrender charges will be levied. The surrender value will be payable in accordance with the NAV of the units at the time of surrender in the underlying funds opted for investment by the policyholder, subject to the policy conditions only." End of quote.
Let's slip into a quick break, but on the other side, is your airline guilty of offering you unsatisfactory in-flight services? You can now sue it. That's coming up in just a bit. Keep watching Fightback.
If you want to register your complaint with us, call us on 022-4098-7444. You can also email us at fightback@btvin.com or follow us on Twitter at fightbackbtv. You can also SMS us. Just type FB space with your complaint in the message box and send it to 0977-327-0010. We will help you fight back.